Hi, I'm Dr. Rajani, and today we're talking about the dreaded jowl and how we can use Kybella as a tool to treat this area. So the jowls, we've talked about it before, but it's a driver to practices. And I want to stress today how we can use Kybella and why we need it. It's a complex problem. It's not simply fat sitting at the edge of the mouth, because our patients walk in and they say, oh, I just have this one problem, and they point here at the edge of the mouth. We talked about the RBF, the angry look, and the downturned mouth in the past, and the jowl plays a role in that as well. We always want to lift from the cheek, in front of the ear, and the all-important jawline, but it reduces the workload of what we need to do in other areas of the face if we can reduce some of the fat in the jowl area, and Kybella is a permanent solution for that. It's deoxycholic acid, and it basically lyses the fat cell. Some of the problems in this area, why we don't use it. Number one, we can ding the nerve that affects smile. And how I deal with it, I just tell patients, and it was done in the trial, we have data for this, about 3 to 5% of the patients will get an irregular smile if they smile big. So I don't treat this area with Kybella if it's an important month or two for the patient, but I do treat it because it's long-term, it's permanent, and it looks great. The other issue with it that I warn patients is they're coming in for the jowl. And they're hyper aware of this area to begin with, and now I'm gonna make it worse. I'm gonna make it swollen. To an observer's eye, they might not even notice that it is swollen, that the downturn is worse, but to the patient, because they're already looking at it, they might see for 2 as much as 6 weeks that this area is swollen. That's a long time for a patient to have that. So there is some hand-holding with the procedure. Patients have to know that up front and time it properly. The swelling goes, and the fact that it's long-term means that we can get them over that hump. We can make them look more and more natural because we don't have to overfill the face to lift the jowl. In treating this area, a lot of people talk about pulling the skin away. I use a needle technique. You'll hear people adding lidocaine or saline or even a cannula technique, whatever floats your boat. I'm a needle guy in this area. Bruising isn't that common. I don't think using a cannula versus a needle offers you any difference in the amount of swelling or the incidence of harming that nerve. And again, the nerve is temporary and it's 3 to 5%. I've seen one in my practice before, but we gear patients that that can happen. So it's a great treatment. Kybella is for the jowl area. I think it's long-term, it's permanent. Patients like that fact. The incidence of side effects is low. We hand-hold them through that swelling a little bit, but it's an area we have to address for a natural look. I hope that helps. Join us on this YouTube channel, on Facebook, and on Instagram for continued helpful tips. Keep your skin and body beautiful, healthy, and vibrant.